Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to my Russ Courtnall Be a Pro series here in NHL 16 on the Xbox One, eagerly awaiting the release of NHL 17 and what they may add to the Be a Pro, if anything. Hopefully there'll be some fun stuff. I know they've talked about some camera-related things, focusing more on your Be a Pro and their individual accomplishments and milestones and big moments. So hopefully that is really put into play with some other elements of Be a Pro that we have not heard yet to date. Here we're taking on the Winnipeg Jets, and well, right off the bat, a goal goes in the net against us. So often we get on the ice and just seconds later the puck ends up in our net. That can be a little frustrating because I sense that sometimes you've got players coming off the ice to get you on when they really should be in the play defending, and that doesn't work out. Right in front, maybe should have held onto that puck a little longer, put the backhand on there, and the save is made, and some pushing and shoving afterwards, already chippy to start this thing off in the first period. And we're down 1-0, trying to erase that deficit. Hear the pass out of the zone, and we're coming up ice. Courtnall gets the puck. He puts it on net, but that is a skate save into the corner. Now we have a face-off and a power play. Win the face-off. Let's work this around. A one-timer is deflected away nicely into the corner. Again, another chance in front. I think that's Richardson. Is denied. We're swarming around, but not getting the puck in the net. Still digging, trying to keep possession. Now Courtnall behind the net. In front, they score and tie it up. Courtnall gets the helper. That's exactly what his game needs to be right there, being a playmaker, setting up teammates, and he does it here to get the equalizer. Brad Richardson puts it in the net, and that's some hard work by the power play unit. Let's watch again. Pass goes behind the net to Courtnall. Out in front to Richardson, who has some space, and he buries it. So it's 1-1 as the Coyotes get on the board. Let's see if we can continue that momentum and steal a road victory here against Winnipeg. Well, that's how the first period's going to end. Knotted at one apiece. We come out for the second. Waiting for Courtnall's line to get the call for the first time in the period. Okay, stepping over the boards, and he is going to try to get back on the defensive end. They're working this puck around, and yeah, just like that, once again, he's only on the ice a few seconds, and the puck is in the Coyotes' net. Lindback cannot make a save right here as Winnipeg's crowd going nuts. They've got their lead back and the momentum. Face off at center ice, and here come the Coyotes trying to work this in. Richardson to Courtnall. Courtnall puts it on net, but that is stopped as it goes behind the net. Again, denied. Not the greatest shot, but that is going to end up being covered at the side of the net. So we go off the ice, and Winnipeg scores again. 3-1. Awaiting another line change. Steps over the boards, and wow, that one was really fast. I guess it can go both ways. We get a goal the second we step on the ice, and we make it a 3-2 game. Okay, well, we definitely have to see a replay here because I'm not sure what Lesio did to put the puck in the net. He gets one shot. He follows this determination. Oh, Pavelich goes down, and he's able to beat him from a sharp angle. Great goal right there to make it just a one-goal game. Yeah, we stepped on the ice for a lot of goals against. That time, Justin stepped foot on as we get the goal. So here's a face-off win. Courtnall gets this out of the zone to Lesio. Lesio working up ice, waiting for his teammates. Going to feed this to Courtnall. Courtnall across. How does he not bury that? What a setup. Could have been his second assist of the night, but instead a beautiful pad save by Pavelich. Now you've got a turnover and a breakaway. Here comes Winnipeg down the ice. And, oh, sick move. Of course he buries it. We have the chance on one end, and it goes the other way. How often do you see that in hockey? Well, we just saw it again. Winnipeg benefits right there from a big pad save by Lesio. Turns it into a turnover. Gets the breakaway goal. Looking put on the brakes here, kind of, and dangle that until the goalie Lindback goes down, and he beats him. Great goal right there, and Winnipeg takes a two-goal lead. Once again at 4-2. Second period, later stages. Here is Courtnall coming up ice. He does not have numbers. He's like 1-on-4. Does make a deke and gets a shot on, but again, a pad save by Pavelich. And that kind of comes dangerously into his crease, but it's worked away. Go off on our line shift here and get some rest. But how do we do that? We score two goals while simming. just bang, bang like that to tie the game 4-4. New life in the third period, mucking and grinding in front, gets a backhander that will not go. Again, Pavlich is frustrating Courtnall. Another chance in front. Defense kind of held him up a little bit there. Gets a shot on net, but it is saved. Power play for Winnipeg. We don't care. We're coming shorthanded. Here comes Courtnall trying to get through. He's got a little space, and he misses the net. Glove side high. Had a glorious chance right there to maybe put Arizona in the lead. But instead, in the waning minutes of the game, and that's a shot on net. Lindback can't find it. It ends up in his own net. I think the defenseman may have put it in inadvertently. Either way, Winnipeg takes a late lead with just 1:16 to play. Ouch. Back and forth game. Had our chances here, but it looks dire right now. He kind of swats at this, not knowing where it is. One way or another, this puck ends up in the net. Yeah, I think the defenseman slid it in there inadvertently, trying to get it out of the crease. He's frustrated. And unfortunately, that is going to be the margin of defeat. We go down 5-4 in kind of a barn burner here in Winnipeg. It's a regulation loss and a hard one to swallow right there. But Winnipeg gets it done on home ice, and they get to salute their fans with a hard-earned 5-4 victory. Coyotes have to turn their attention from this and move on. You see the three stars dominated by the Winnipeg Jets. I don't know. It's kind of back and forth there. I think we could have had one of those stars, but no. Update on our injury. I forgot we had an injury. Obviously, it was not bad enough to keep us out of the lineup. We played through it, but that's still going on. So we sim a little bit, and oh, okay, I guess the injury is now not an issue whatsoever. He's fully healed. So whatever that was doing to our attributes or stats, it is gone now. And we've got a game coming up against the Chicago Blackhawks. This is going to be a home game for the Coyotes. See if we can take it too. Taze and Kane and company. Both teams enter with winning records. This should be some good hockey. Chicago, no surprise, scores the first goal of the game and is up 1-0. We got a face-off in the Chicago end, though, and it's a win. Try to get this on net. Courtnall, it's a goal, but no, wait, they wave it off. Looks like a teammate may have been in the crease at the time he put it in. You see him fighting for the puck. He slides it in on Crawford, but no, they wave it off because Richardson is in the blue paint. No goal. Courtnall's goal erased, and we're still down 1-0 in this hockey game. Midway through the first period, face-off on our end. Blackhawks win it. Oh, but look at that. It's picked off by Lesio, and he's off to the races. Breakaway, and he scores on Crawford on the forehand. No assist there. That's going to be an unassisted goal, although you see that they were passing around, and Courtnall made him think twice about going to the net with it. And then a pass that they wish they would have had back right on the tape. Alessio, who was gone, splitting the D and able to beat Crawford stick side. We've got a tie hockey game, and the Coyotes have their crowd into it now. All right, let's try to get the next one here and take the lead. Will it happen? Just seconds left in the first period. And stop me if we've said this before, but hopping over the boards only to see Brian Bickle put it in the net. This starts an onslaught for the Blackhawks. Unfortunately, they get a little momentum going, and it is not going to stop for a while. Here's a chance just toying with the Arizona D right there. It is in the net, and 3-1 Blackhawks as they continue to come at him in the second period and waves that pass across the crease. My goodness, somebody get a stick on that. It's in the net, and it's Bickle again. He's got two. 4-1 Blackhawks. They're not done. This is just seconds later. Passing around, and again a one-timer, and again in the Arizona net. It is Marian Hossa this time, making it 5-1. Let's get out of this period. It's been terrible. Well, we still have half of it to play. Courtnall over the boards. Here come the Coyotes on the rush. Pass in front of the net. Save. No, he couldn't get all of it. It ends up in the net. Crawford got a piece of it, but not enough. And it is a goal, so finally we answer and make it 5-2, but we've got a long way to come back right here. Richardson will get the goal from Lesio. And let's watch it on a couple replay angles. Nice center by Lesio. Richardson, good shot. And like I said, Crawford did everything he could to keep it out of the net, but it pops up in the air behind him and takes a fortunate Arizona bounce. So 5-2. Maybe the momentum's ours now. Can we get back into this? Lesio to Courtnall. Courtnall can't get a shot on net. It goes into the corner. They're going to work on the forecheck. They get the putt back. Richardson in front to Lesio. Lesio buries it. It's 5-3. Okay, maybe we're going to get back in this hockey game. Second period's been a wild one for both sides, as now this is Lesio getting one back from Richardson. These two clicking well. Let's watch it again. Behind the net working. Richardson backhand pass. Lesio gets the shot. Courtnall was in front of the net trying to provide a little bit of a screen. Don't know if he did that or not, but they get the puck in the net one way or another, and it's 5-3. Blackhawks say that's cute, but here we come again, passing this around. Eventually, a shot on net is going to go in. I think it was redirected in front, and I think that's a hat trick for Mr. Bickle. It's 6-3. Oh, make that 7-3. Just a minute left in the game. Blackhawks have poured on the offense in this one. Coyotes trying to just get something right here. Pass in front. Courtnall's denied. Same shift. 43 seconds left. That is going the other way. Courtnall's got it. 1-on-3. He's going to hang onto the puck. Puts it. Well, tries to put it on net. He misses wide. And here's another chance that's blocked. That's how this game goes for the Coyotes. The last seconds ticking down. But, yeah, why not add another one for good measure? The Blackhawks just sniping all night long. 8-3, they're going to take home this one. They never let up on the gas wearing those sweet Stadium Series jerseys. Well, I guess the debate's out on whether they're sweet or not. You guys like them? I think they're pretty cool. Hey, they were won in the game against the Wild, so that was fun for me. Anyway, looks like our defensive numbers took a hit because of that game, the 8-goal performance by the Blackhawks. That's going to do it for this Russ Courtnell episode. Leave a like, and we'll see you next time.
Thanks for watching videos here on SGU. Go ahead and subscribe on YouTube at Sports Gaming Universe. Follow me on Twitter at NotusFan for all the latest info. And go ahead and check out that official Facebook page as well. Looking for SGU merchandise? SportsGamingUniverse.Spreadshirt.com is the place.